All this stress, all this pressure, and I'm raising you until you got grown, and now you need to make some adult decisions. Amen. Trying to feed you with the in crowd. You can't do that. They'll end up getting going away scot free, you end up getting caught. Tell me, crackhead, you know, they don't even smoke much crack or nothing like that, but they'll give it to you free.
Yeah.
Until they get you hooked. Yeah. Then you got to pay for it the rest of your life.
Amen.
That's an addiction that you don't want to bother.
So down.
Amen. There are preachers, pastors, that have had that addiction and are struggling with it today.
Oh, Lord. Lord help them.
Amen. Missionaries. Highly favored, highly honored God.
Yeah.
That crack addiction is something else.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
When the last party I went to was in 1980, I prayed and asked the Lord, I said, Lord, you know, I was talking crazy. God, you have no sense. I told the Lord, I said, Lord, if you let me enjoy this Christmas. You know, in 1980, they let me have enjoy this Christmas. I want to party one more time. So I went to this party with my friend, who I thought was my friend, and I had never seen cocaine before. I'm bringing them from the country. We were down in Midtown. We walked up in that party, and the music was jumping, and the strobe light was flashing. And I noticed they had some money rolled up, and this big pile of white stuff was on the table. Everybody was hitting me, running up on the nose, and they were falling out like that.
Wow.
I thought the strobe light was making them fall out. So I leaned up against the wall because I'm going to go fall out on the floor. But I had never saw that before.
Yeah.
But come to find out later, they were snorting cocaine.
Yeah.
So the devil saw that was a snort process. Really destroying them or killing them.
Yeah.
So they decided they could cook it and make it into a rock. And they put it in a cigarette or in what they call a blunt. And they would smoke it. And once they made it crack cocaine, once they put it in the oven and cooked it, man, it hooked for the rest of his life.
Messed up.
The rest of his life. Because the marijuana too slow to get high. Let me give you something to get you right there. But then tell them the first time you try, you're hooked for the rest of your life.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
And I walked away from that body and I said, Lord, get me up out of here.
Yes, Lord.
And I seen guys that have a crack addiction, but they see a little piece of white stuff on the floor. They think it's a piece of crap. They'll clean your carpet for you. You don't have to pay. That's funny, but it's true.
Yeah, I know.
You think you can try it. You think you can break the law. But the law is for the lawless. Sooner or later, you're going to get caught.
Amen.
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 Don't do it.
Don't do it.
Don't get on that crack cocaine. Amen. Like the man got on crack. Y'all don't let me talk to you.
I don't know. You're preaching. Teaching.
One or two scriptures. I'm not going to be on. And the Lord said the same. But this brother was living in an abandoned house. A crackhead. An old dog came in one night with cold. Dog walked in, and the crackhead said the dog spoke to him. Now, God used the rooster to crow three times and tell people, you now. He opened the mouth of a dumb ass and spoke to Baal, the false prophet, and told him you're going the wrong way. Now, he knew the dog, though.
Yes, he
supposed to live like this.
Yeah.
But you a man.
Yeah.
You living worse than I am.
Yeah.
And that brother said he sobered up. Some of y'all were here, he testified right over there. That deal. A backslidden preacher said a dog helped him to come back to God.
Thank you, God.
Let me tell you something. Though God loves, he don't change. He'll whip you.
Yes, he will.
He'll discipline you.
Yes, he will.
You can't get out there and do what you want to do.
Amen.
You don't want God, go to whipping on God.
Mm.
So, too many people are faint. Let me read this scripture again. 2 Corinthians 4 and 16. I gave you one scripture in Galatians 6 and 9. If you don't faint, if you don't give up, you're going to reap. People are fainting spiritually. For which cause we faint not. But though, you got to listen to what the word said.
Mm-hmm.
Though. It didn't say it was. It says, that's 2 Corinthians 4:16. For which cause we faint not. But though it looked like, that's what though said, it looked like the outward man perish means stop existing. Look like you're not even existing. You don't have a life. Though it looked like the outward man perish. Yet the inward man, God is doing something on the inside.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you, when God is working on the inside,
amen,
it's going to show up on the outside.
Yeah, it will.
Amen. That's what he wants. He wants to work on the inside.
Work, Lord.
And it looks like, from our viewpoint, that we're perishing.
Mm.
It looks like it. It feels like it sometimes. Your life is heading down here.
Mm-hmm.
It's still going up here. But the devil is alive.
Amen.
If you're in God and you're in Jesus Christ, you're not going down, but you're going up.
Thank you, Lord.
Though it look like down with men perish, he is renewed day by day. Somebody say, have your way, Lord.
Have your way, Lord.
For our light affliction, our light troubles, our light situation, our light setbacks, problems, is but
for a moment.
Yes, sir. Working for us, they fall
to our feet. Working for us is working.
Yes, sir.
My troubles, they working for us. My afflictions, they work.
Mm-hmm.
Afflictions don't necessarily mean that you got affliction in your body.
Mm-hmm.
But it could be trouble.
Yeah.
It could be persecution.
Yeah.
It could be a trial.
Mm-hmm.
It could be a hard test.
Yeah.
But it says it's working for us.
Mm-hmm.
A far more exceeding. Listen, eternal way of going. That's why Paul said in Romans 8:28, we know that
all things
work together for the good of those who love the Lord. Your rough days is working for you. The days you have to cry is working for you. The days you feel like God is not with you is working for you.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to tell somebody about affliction.
It's just light.
But they're working for me.
But they're working for me.
All eternal weight of glory. But I can't faint, y'all. I can't faint in the midst of going through.
Amen.
I can't faint in the midst of holding on. I can't faint in the midst of holding out. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Because God is working something much better for me. If you don't believe it, just look behind.
Come on now.
and see what you already been doing.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
See what he already brought you through.
Yes.
Somebody can shake their head and say, I never would have made it.
Yeah. Never would have.
I heard one pastor say, don't sing that song in my church. Because they don't mention Jesus' name. But common sense tells me.
But
I know while the Sabbath was singing that song, he said, I never would have made it without you, Lord.
Yep.
He might not have written his name nowhere in that song. But how many of you know you never would have made it?
Amen.
Except God was on your side.
Yeah.
You wouldn't be sitting here today in your right mind. Except God had been on your side.
Thank you, God.
You would have lost your mind.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
But you're here today. You can look back and see where God has brought you from. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I don't know about you, but I have to look back sometimes.
Yeah.
I don't look back to go back.
Yeah.
But I look back to see. When I get to a place and look back, I can't make it. And Tom Trumpet put out a song saying, if he done that, he can do this. Oh, well, he can do it again.
Yeah, he can.
Come on, tell somebody, he can do it again.
He can do it again.
If he can heal you one time.
Yeah.
He can heal you.
Yes, he can.
If he got you out of trouble one time.
One time. Yes.
He can do it again.
Yeah. Again.
If he paid your bills one time.
One time.
He can do it again.
Yeah.
If he way down and pick me up.
Yes,
I'm going to look at
him. Yes, he can.
They sold to the Israelites, God knew where he was.
Mm-hmm.
When Potiphar bought him, God knew where he was.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
When he ended up in prison, God knew where he was.
Yes, he did.
When he went from the prison to the palace.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And sometimes we have people that look like they're doing us an injustice.
Mm-hmm.
But we got to realize they are part of your text.
Thank you, Lord.
They help you to make you be what you supposed to be.
Yes.
But you got to take it the right way.
Thank you, Lord.
Job could have took it the wrong way with his family.
Yeah.
But when he finally reunited with his family, he said, you didn't believe.
Mm-hmm.
But God made it for good.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's why we got to look at situations, tests and trials.
Mm-hmm.
God meant it for my good.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
It might be painful, but it meant it for my good.
Yeah. Thank you.
And the 18th verse says,
While we look not at the things
which are seen,
but the things which are not seen.
But you gotta look at the things which are not seen. Sometimes we focus on just what we see and miss what we don't see. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord was dealing with me a few weeks ago, and I was sharing with someone about believe what you see. Many times God is speaking to us through vision. He's showing us, but we count showing it also. We don't take it as if it's God. We take it as, well, it's something that passed through my mind. No, God don't work like that.
Thank you, Lord.
Sometimes you got to believe what you see that's not visible.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, church.
Amen.
God is speaking to us all the time. And he'll bring things to our mind and to our sight, spiritual sight, that we have never seen before. And because it's from God, sometimes we overlook it.
Mm-hmm.
And he can give it us our answer all the time.
Thank you, Lord.
But we so into the natural realm.
Mm-hmm.
What we see, you gotta believe it before you see it.
Yeah.
Well, you got to see it
before you believe it.
Before you believe it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Come on.
So while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, but the things which are seen is temporary.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It's temporary.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the song says, things are not going to always be like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's temporary. But the things which are not seen are eternal. Saints, I just want to use one word with you today, and I know if I see it. Don't faint.
Amen.
Don't faint in the midst of what you're in. Don't give up on God, because He won't give up on you. Your life afflictions, they just fall on. But you got to hang on in there.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Knowing that God is in control of everything.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
Ain't nothing happening that He don't know about. And what's happening, He's allowing it to happen.
Yep.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We can't figure it out. We can't see it.
Oh, God.
But Lord, I'm just going to trust you.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm just going to believe that you are God.
Yeah.
In my favor.
Yeah, in my favor.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to stop praising. I'm not going to stop being faithful.
Yeah.
But I'm going to hold on.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Galatians 5 and 7 say, ye did run away. But who hindered you?
Yes.
Tell me who it was.
Yeah.
Who? He said, this persuasion didn't come from me. I wouldn't cause you to run away.
Yeah.
Didn't tell you to stop.
Yeah.
He said, but a little bit. Live it the whole month.
Yeah.
If you got something in you that need to come out.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't take but just a little yeast. Amen.
Amen.
Cause to bring it to rise.
Amen.
If you looked at the light bread before they put the yeast in it, it wouldn't be a whole loaf.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be something about this size.
Mm.
That's why they call it light bread. If you're the whole loaf, it won't be full. Because you ain't getting nothing. But when the children of Israel got ready to leave Egypt, the Lord told them, don't put no yeast in the bread.
Yeah.
Because we got to get out of here and face.
Uh-huh.
We ain't going to have time for this stay in the hood and rise.
Amen.
Amen. He told me he bitter herbs. That they would remember what God has done for them.
Amen.
God don't ever want us to forget what he's done.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Never the bitterness of our life cause us to appreciate all of the goodness God has done. People that never experienced bitterness, you really can't love God, know God. Because if he never did anything for you, how can we help somebody? You got to go through to help somebody else. Amen.
Amen.
Ain't nothing wrong with going through. Mr. Gene Patterson said, whatever you do, just don't get stuck.
Amen.
Amen. Just go on through. Blessing to be going through. Saints, we are more blessed than we realize.
Amen.
Amen. If we get to do like Job, we need to maintain our ways.
Well,
y'all know the end of Job's story. He maintained his way.
Mm-hmm.
Kept the same way. When he lost his family and wealth, he got sick. He kept the what? Same way.
Mm-hmm.
In the end, God doubled.
Yeah.
Everything that the devil took.
Yeah.
But he didn't fight, y'all. I want that word to sink in on today. We get tired, but we don't fight.
Yeah.
Amen. Always get tired.
Amen.
That's why I'm going home and let y'all have church tonight if you want. I'm tired.
Amen.
But I'm not fighting.
Yeah. Bless the Lord.
Ain't nowhere near fight.
Yeah.
Fight is not going to give up.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You want to be right? Throw in the towel.
Mm-hmm.
I heard someone say yesterday about Sugar Ray Leonard and Roberto Duran, the fighter of the century. Said they were in the eighth round. And he said, what? No boss. No boss in Spanish means. I can't tell you no more. And he threw the towel in.
Yeah.
Who knows he had four more rounds to go. He might have could have knocked him out.
Yeah.
But when you throw the towel in, there is no possibility of victory. Come on, man. I'm not going to throw the towel in. Your loyalty to God should not depend upon